So in this video, I'm going to share one of the important topic, that is scrutiny assessment. This is your lecture number 11 and this topic already comes in June 2018 examinations, carries 5 marks. So very important for your examination point of view. This is chapter number 19, assessment procedure. Okay, so scrutiny assessment kya hai? As you know, in income tax, there are 4 types of assessment. These are summary assessment under section 143 subsection 1, summary assessment under section 143 subsection 1, then scrutiny assessment under section 143 subsection 3, then best judgment assessment under section 144, then income escaping assessment under section 147. पहले इसके लिख लीजिए, नोट कर दीजिए. समरी असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 1, देन स्क्रूटिनी असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 3, देन बेस्ट जजमेंट असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 144, देन इनकम एस्केपिंग असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 147. देर आर 4 टाइप्स ऑफ असेसमेंट इन इनकम टैक्स, राइट. सो स्क्रूटिनी असेसमेंट under section 143 subsection 3 kehta hai, provide that if a return is filed having a claim of refund, ek return file hua hai usme kuch refund claim hai, and the case is selected for scrutiny under section 143 subsection 2, then in that case such return shall not be processed under section 143 subsection 1. अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 1, जिसको कहते हैं समरी असेसमेंट. समरी असेसमेंट, समरी असेसमेंट, राइट. सो देन इट मीन्स दैट रिफंड शैल नॉट बी ग्रांटेड टू एसेसी अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 1 if case is selected for scrutiny, refund if any shall be granted in assessment under section 143 subsection 3, which is called scrutiny assessment under section 143, which is called scrutiny assessment. Scrutiny assessment. Okay. It means that refund shall not be granted to assessee under section 143 subsection 1 if case is selected for scrutiny. In that case, refund if any shall be granted in assessment under section 143 subsection 3, that is scrutiny assessment. The resulted in hardship to the assessee as their refund was upheld till the scrutiny under section 143 subsection 3 is passed. Finance Act 2017 provides that section 143 subsection 1D shall not apply to returns filed for assessment year 2017-18 and the future assessment years. That means for assessment year 2017-18 and future assessment years, if return is filed having a claim of refund and the case is selected for scrutiny under section 143 subsection 2, then the refund shall be granted to the assessee under section 143 subsection 1. The income tax department cannot stop the refund till the completion of assessment under section 143 subsection 3. So agar simple bhasha mein samjha jaye to here स्कोप ऑफ असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 3, स्कोप क्या है? द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ स्क्रूटिनी असेसमेंट इज टू कन्फर्म दैट द टैक्स पेयर हैज नॉट अंडरस्टेटेड द इनकम और हैज नॉट कंप्यूटेड एक्सेसिव लॉस और हैज नॉट अंडरपेड द टैक्स इन एनी मैनर. दिस इज द स्कोप ऑफ असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 3. एंड व्हाट आर द प्रोसीजर्स ऑफ मेकिंग असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 143 subsection 3, notice under section 143 subsection 2 shall be served with a period of 6 months from the end of the financial year in which the return is filed. The taxpayer or his representative assessee will appear before the assessing officer and will place his argument, supporting, etc. on various matters, issues as required by the assessing officer. After that, after hearing verifying such evidence and taking into account such particular as the taxpayer may produce, the assessing officer shall by an order in writing make an assessment of total income or loss of the taxpayer and determine the sum payable by him or refund of any amount due to him on the basis of such assessment. Then, what are the time limit to complete assessment under section 143 subsection 3? As per section 153, the time limit for making assessment under section 143 subsection 3 is 12 months from the end of the assessment year in which the income was first assessable, that is assessment year 2019-20 and onwards. Remember, the time limit to complete assessment under section 143 subsection 3, as per section 153, the time limit for making assessment under section 143 subsection 3 is 12 months from the end of the assessment year in which the income was first assessable. Okay, so this is the example. Suppose assessment year 1930 and assessment year ends with 31st March 2020. In that case, assessment order under section 143 subsection 3, that is scrutiny assessment, must be passed on or before 31st March 2021, that is within 12 months from within 12 months from 31st March 2020. ओके उसके बाद अगर कुछ रिफंड होगा तो फिर रिफंड प्रोसेस किया जाएगा एसेसी को, अदरवाइज नॉट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड स्क्रूटिनी असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 3. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, यू जस्ट नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट एटलीस्ट देर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ असेसमेंट इन इनकम टैक्स. One is summary assessment under section 143 subsection 1, then scrutiny assessment under section 143 subsection 3, then best judgment assessment under section 144, income escaping assessment under section 147. इसके ऊपर में हम लोग वीडियो बनाएंगे. सो नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस scrutiny assessment under section 143 subsection 3. सो दिस इज scrutiny assessment under section 143. Section 143 subsection 1d provide that if a return is filed having a claim of refund and the case is selected for scrutiny under section 143 subsection 2, then such return shall not be processed under section 143 subsection 1. It means that refund shall not be granted to assessee under section 143 subsection 1 if case is selected for scrutiny, and a refund if any shall be granted in assessment under section 143 subsection 3, that is scrutiny assessment. So scrutiny assessment ka object hota hai to confirm that the taxpayer has not understated the income or has not computed excessive loss or has not underpaid the tax in any manner. After such consideration, refund if any can be processed after completion of assessment year. Okay, the resulted in hardship to the assessee of as their refund was upheld till the scrutiny under section 143 is passed. The jab tak section 43 subsection 3 order pass nahi hua hai tab tak रिफंड पास नहीं हो सकता एसएससी को. सो व्हिच इज रिजल्टेड इन हार्डशिप टू द एसएससी एंड व्हाट आर द प्रोसीजर ऑफ मेकिंग असेसमेंट अंडर सेक्शन 1 अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 3. नोटिस अंडर सेक्शन 143 सबसेक्शन 2 शैल बी सर्व विद ए पीरियड ऑफ 6 मंथ फ्रॉम द एंड ऑफ द फाइनेंशियल ईयर इन व्हिच द रिटर्न इज फाइल्ड. द टैक्स पेयर और हिज रिप्रेजेंटेटिव एसएससी will appear before the assessing officer and will place his argument supporting etc. on various matters issues as required by the assessing officer. Okay, and then after hearing, verifying such evidence and taking into account such particulars as the taxpayer may produce, the assessing officer shall by an order in writing make an assessment of total income or loss of the taxpayer and then decide the sum payable by him or refund of any amount due to him on the basis of such assessment. What are the time limit to complete such assessment? As you know that as per section 153, the time limit for making assessment under section 143 subsection 3 is 12 months from the end of the assessment year in which the income was first assessable. That is, for example, if assessment year 1920, then assessment year end hota hai 31 March 2020 ko. Assessment order under section 143 subsection 3, that is scrutiny assessment, must be passed on or before 31st March 2021. That is within 12 months from the assessment year, from the end of the assessment year, that is 31st March 2020. Okay, so this is it all about scrutiny assessment. उसके बाद हम लोग पढ़ेंगे बाकी जो remaining जो remaining types of assessment है, that is summary assessment under section 143(1) and best judgment assessment under section 144 and income escaping assessment under section 147. So for now, this is it all about from my side. Thank you so much for your time and thank you so much for your support. Happy studying.